Hello everyone, I have some crazy content coming, so buckle up. So this was actually on the news here. This happened in Rochester, New York. Didn't happen directly to me but to my brother's girlfriend, Jay. So Jay is a nurse in the maternity ward. Basically she helps women give birth. This was back in March or April I believe, when people had only just started to realize coronavirus was the real deal. So one night Jay is working with this one woman and the dad isn't there. Not at first. The new mom says he has the symptoms of corona and can't come up. She's like, "Ite, that makes sense," and leaves it alone. Guess who wouldn't stay home? The dad faked some symptoms so he could pass hospital security and he made his way up to the maternity ward to see his wife and kid. People found out and he got kicked out. He essentially put the entire ward at risk of corona. He could have killed his frickin' kid. The next day Jay had a bad fever. She got tested and thankfully didn't have corona, but it was scary AF. So a little background information, I, 22F, work in a pretty big cheese factory, and every month we get a huge block of cheese from the factory to take home with us. Since the cheese is made in the factory I work, it is wrapped in plastic foil and it doesn't have any brand name or logo written on it or whatsoever. This will be important information for later in the story. Today was a day we received a block of cheese, and when I was done with work I went to the supermarket to do some groceries. My cheese was in my backpack when I was using the self-checkout, that thing where you can scan your own groceries and pay without having contact with a cashier. While I was scanning my groceries, there was a woman next to me, EP, who looked, well, like a 40-year-old who still thinks she is 15. She was giving me weird looks while I was putting the groceries in my bag, but I thought nothing of it since people often look weird at me after I go somewhere after work. As you can expect, working in a cheese factory doesn't exactly give you a nice body odor. I've been given comments about this from strangers from time to time, but when I say that I work with cheese they apologize and say they understand. Until she decided to speak to me, op, guess who? EP, the Karen with a midlife crisis. SA, store attendant. SM, supermarket manager. EP, excuse me? Op, sorry, what's the problem, madam? EP, I think you forgot to scan that block of cheese, points to block of cheese in my bag. OP, oh sorry, but that's not from here. I work in a factory where we get these every month for free, but I understand the confusion. EP, so you stole it. Op, I'm no madam, like I said every employee gets cheese from the company, I didn't steal anything. By this time I was done with checking out and I was feeling kind of anxious by EP her accusation, so I grabbed everything and left quickly to refrain from the discussion getting out of hand, and went to the customer service counter to buy cigarettes. In my country you have to buy them there. At this moment I thought it was over, but as always with entitled parents, it's never over when you think you lost them. As I was paying for the cigarettes, EP decided to show up behind me and started screaming in the most awful voice. EP, she is stealing. I caught her but she is lying and is trying to get away with it. This is why this country is becoming more of a poop show. Me turning around with the biggest really brew face, madam, I just told you that. EP, check her bag. There is a huge block of cheese there that she is trying to steal. SA, faces towards me, madam, may I check your bag? I say no problem and grab the block of cheese while I explain her about the free cheese deal from my company. All this while EP is screaming lies in the background. In the meanwhile SM noticed the ruckus and came to ask what was happening. Of course EP immediately faces towards her and starts ranting about how they dare to allow thieves in their store. SM faces towards me and asks, "Miss, is this true?" Op, not in the slightest, like I just said to your colleague I get this cheese from work every month. You can even check security cameras if you'd like. EP, yes, do that. She is trying to get away with IT. And then suddenly SA decided to say something, SM, I think the young girl isn't lying. This cheese is wrapped in plastic foil and it don't have any brand name, nor do we sell fresh blocks of cheese here, they only sell packaged blocks. After hearing this EP face turns pale. And again when I thought it was over, it wasn't. EP, well then if you got it for free you should give IT to me since I'm a stay-at-home mother and I deserve IT more. Give IT to me. Op, SA, SM, 10 seconds of absolute silence to think about what the hell was actually happening. SM, madam please keep it down, this girl didn't steal anything nor bothered anyone, so let her be or else I'm going to ask you to leave. EP, but it's not fair. I'm a stay-at-home mom, so I'm an essential worker, so I deserve IT and not this young brat. SM. But she got this from work, and if she is still working, doesn't that make her an essential worker? After this EP, Usain bolted out of the store while mumbling something about immigrants getting everything they want. I'm not an immigrant, but since I have dark hair and eyes, people never believe me when I say I don't have roots from any other country. I thanked the store manager and attendant and apologized for wasting their time on such a weird matter. So I work in a preschool, and you would think I get a lot of interaction with entitled parents, but honestly I don't. Most of our parents are great and willing to work with us to help us help their kids in the best ways possible. This was not one of those parents. In light of COVID-19, quite a few of our parents made the decision to pull their kids, whether they had lost their jobs or were working from home or had someone immunocompromised at home. Wise decisions that I don't blame them for, but left many seats open for more kids to be enrolled. Cast, M entitled mom. Pound little boy. LG little girl. D director of the preschool, basically in charge of everything when the owner isn't around. So M calls and enrolls her two kids in the school, a 5-year-old boy and a 2, almost 3-year-old girl. Bad kids. Pound tries to run out of the school after his mom had to carry around a blanket, not allowed, and refuses to eat the food we provide and behaved worse than our 1-year-olds. LG was a bit better, prone to the same temper tantrums, hitting, and had to carry around a baby Moana doll, also not allowed. We gave her the benefit of the doubt though. M claims there was no way, but she very clearly displayed signs of being on the autism spectrum. Either way, they're there for about a week, give or take a few days for Pound, who refused to come and was kept home with someone else, when the LG is one of multiple kids who got sent home with NITS. Now according to our latest DCF, Department of Children and Families, check-in, we are one of the cleanest still operating childcare facilities in the county. However, in any childcare environment, lice is an inevitable consequence of having a whole bunch of kids around. It's no fault of anybody's, it's just a fact of life. Most parents understand that. The procedure for any isolated case of lice is that when the child returns to school, the parent must give proof that the child was treated, a picture or receipt for the bottle of treatment, the recipe for a home remedy, etc. The child is checked to make sure they're clean, everything is documented, and life goes on. So it's the next day, and M, Pound, and LG are some of the first few kids in the door despite being the last to go home. M shows D a video on her phone of her treating LG's head. D, you're going to have to send me that so I can figure out how to add it to the documentation. M starts getting pissy at this point. I come back from making my breakfast smoothie in the kitchen and sign the kids in and escort them to seats, taking their blankets and putting them in their cubbies and keeping Pound from trying to get up and run out of the door while D explains the next steps to M. D, so we had kids from 7 different families sent home with lice yesterday. Any more than 2 and I have to call the health department. M, getting tense, what? I don't understand, you need to explain. At this point, D clears her throat and takes a drink of water. This sets M off further for some reason. D, we had kids from 7 different families sent home with NITS yesterday. That is considered an epidemic. For the next 18 days, we have to do daily head checks and monitor the number of children with lice. If the number goes down, we're all good, but if the number goes up, the health department will get involved and go to the houses of the kids with lice to rule them out as the source of the bugs before the blame is shifted to us as a facility. M storms over and yanks LG out of her chair by the arm. Oh no, my kids are not going to stay here. You're not going to get an attitude with me and accuse my kids of causing all this. D, ma'am, what are you talking about? That's not at all what I meant. M, you know what I'm talking about. You've been extremely rude to me and you're accusing me of bringing lice here and I'm leaving. Let's go, Pound. D, wait. M, have a nice day, slams door behind her. This was 2 days ago. As far as I know, none of the staff has heard from her since. It's a shame. LG is adorable despite her tantrums and I'll kind of miss her. I sincerely hope M wakes up and realizes she's very likely on the spectrum and is able to adapt to her needs. What did you think? What would you have done differently? Share your opinions in the comments. And if you enjoyed the stories, slap that like and subscribe button for more of them, and don't forget to support the original writers with an upvote, links are in the description. Peace out, and catch you tomorrow.